Police are still searching for the family of a woman whose body was found in a vacant home 7 months ago.
That got the NBC2 investigators wondering what happened to unclaimed bodies and who's responsible for properly disposing them. NBC2's Jim Spiewak did some digging and found out how much it's costing taxpayers to do that.
Kelly and Peter, this is an interesting one. State law says each county must have its own policy that states how to properly cremate or bury unclaimed bodies. But we found one county here in Southwest Florida without a policy until we came calling.
The winds at Indian Springs Cemetery give a voice to the unclaimed, reminding us that they too should be remembered.
You're born and you die, and it's the dash in between that counts.
But sometimes at the end of the line, there's no one there.
The body has to be properly disposed of.
Only after law enforcement exhausts every option to find the next of kin does the county step in.
There is not a law that requires somebody to bury their family member.
Since 2010, in Charlotte, Lee, and Collier, more than $123,000 taxpayer dollars have been spent cremating and burying 283 unclaimed bodies.
It falls then on the funeral homes or the counties to make sure that those people have a final resting place.
When a body in Florida goes unclaimed, state law requires each of its 67 counties to have its own plan to deal with it. In Charlotte, every funeral home enters into a rotational program. When it's their turn, they dispose of the body.
We see that all the time where family members are estranged from their relatives and they're not to be found or they just don't want to have anything to do with it.
In Lee, funeral homes bid on a multi-year contract. Gendron Funeral Services has held the business for the last 4 years and they must follow a strict set of rules.
The funeral home has to hold unclaimed bodies for at least 120 days after disposition. If somebody comes forward, we would then release the cremains.
Collier and DeSoto have plans as well, but the NBC2 investigators found Hendry County has never had a policy, a violation of state law. County leaders declined to be interviewed on camera, but sent a statement saying they're in the process of drafting one. They did not provide figures of how many bodies they've buried. In a place like this, reminded death is an experience that's infinitely different.
It's something we're all going to face one day.
Especially when no one is there to claim you.
Now, remains are scattered at sea, and that is done by the funeral homes and veterans in this area. They are given a proper burial in the Sarasota National Cemetery. Reporting in the studio, Jim Spiewak, NBC2.